Our surrounding environment is contaminated with various bacteria, fungi, and viruses. This can affect our health in various ways, causing diseases and infections. To reduce the effect of such microorganisms, in hospitals, industrial manufacturing units, and offices, various government and semi-government institutions, the fumigation activity becomes essential. The chemical disinfectant solution used for fumigation has a wide range of germicidal action, ensuring total disinfection of rooms, and is approved by US FDA. It has a broad spectrum, bactericidal, fungicidal, and sporicidal activity. Now we will see the practical demonstration of room fumigation. During the fumigation, it is mandatory to wear personal protective equipments. You can see that in the room which has to be fumigated, all the electrical appliances such as electrical switchboards, computers, air conditioners, fans, exhaust fans have been switched off and covered with a thick plastic sheet so that these equipments are safe and are not affected by the chemical during the fogging operation. The fogger machine is connected to a 15 ampere switch and the nozzle of the machine is kept at an angle of 45 degrees. Due care has been taken that there are no obstacles in front of the fogger while the fogging operation is going on. Before starting the fogging operation, you can see that all the doors and windows of the room have been closed. The fogger machine has been switched on and it is dispensing the disinfectant solution under pressure in the form of mist or aerosols. These aerosols help in killing the bacteria and viruses which are present in the air. After the fumigation is done, the chemical disinfectant is effective for about 12 hours. Since the machine is auto-stop, after 5 minutes it will automatically get switched off. The machine is then removed from the room and the room is sealed for 12 hours. After 12 hours, the disinfected room is being opened, but avoid entering the room immediately. After 5 minutes, open the windows of the room to allow fresh air to come in. In this way, the aerial disinfection of the room has been done. Now we will carry out the mopping process, which will make the room disinfection more effective. In the fogging procedure, the bacteria and viruses in the air are killed. However, due to constant movement of people in the office rooms and their contact with the doors, walls, and furniture increases the chances of microbial contamination in the room. Therefore, mopping is very effective way by which such surfaces can be disinfected. Now we are seeing the mopping process. We are using the 3-bucket system for this process. In the first bucket, we have taken clean water for rinsing the mop. The second bucket contains the disinfectant solution. The third one is used for collecting the wastewater, which is obtained after the mop is rinsed. Now we can see that the wall is being cleaned with a clean weight mop. After that, the mop is dipped in the first bucket containing clean water and rinsed. Thereafter, the mop is dipped in the second bucket containing the disinfectant solution and the walls are being cleaned. At each step, the excess liquid from the mop is squeezed out in the third bucket for wastewater collection. The walls and other surfaces of the room should remain wet for at least 15 to 20 minutes to increase the germicidal activity of the disinfectant. We have observed that due to the rising bacterial, fungal, and viral infections, sanitization and disinfection has become a necessary activity. For bigger indoor spaces and outdoor air foggers of bigger capacities can be used. This process of fogging and mopping has been approved by the World Health Organization, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and the Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. To avail the services of room disinfection through fogging and mopping, you can contact us on 9373258215 and 9325385525. You can send an email to us, sales@ashwamedh.net.